A lot of RBI aspirants keep calling me and want to know why they or others received very low marks in the interview this year, as low as 2 out of 50. On the other hand, a lot of students received very high marks in the interview, as high as 49 out of 50. In order to understand it and answer it perfectly, we need to first of all understand and internalize and believe in the board's capability of giving us fair marks. If we start questioning the board itself, then we are diverging from the real issue as to why did the board decide to give us as low as 2 marks out of 50. Therefore, we need to understand and believe that the board is capable, that the board does justice to every student, irrespective of his caste, irrespective of his region, irrespective of his or her gender. And the board knows what is best for RBI as an institution. Therefore, before questioning or without questioning the board's capability, we need to question ourselves and try and ask ourselves, why did we receive so low marks in the interview? The reason that I can understand through a lot of discussion with selected students and also discussion with students who went in for the interview and received less marks is that the RBI board this year is very clearly decided on who to select and who not to select. So, if the board is convinced that you should be in RBI, it would not shy away from giving you as high marks as 49 out of 50 in order to make sure that you enter RBI. On the other hand, if the board is convinced that you're not good enough, you need more time to prepare better, that there is something wrong with you and you will not be an asset for RBI, instead will be a liability for RBI, the board will not shy away from giving you as low marks as 2 or 3 out of 50. This is not a new phenomena. Before 2013, the same phenomena used to be followed by RBI. People used to get as low as 5 or 6 out of 50. Therefore, this is not an outlier year. This is in fact going back to the basics by RBI and making sure that people who enter the organization are convinced, people who enter the organization are capable, people who enter the organization are there for long term and will not leave the organization. In short, it wants to make sure that people who enter RBI turn into assets for RBI and not liabilities for RBI. I want to finish here. I don't want to make this video very long because otherwise it might confuse a lot of you. With only these 2 points, we can try and understand the interview board's mindset, the interview board's direction on how to scale your performance in the interview. If we keep these two things in mind, I'm very sure the students who are going to write the interview or go for the interview next year will be better prepared, will be more in line with the thoughts of the interview panel and will take their interview more seriously, considering that the interview panel can take a very dangerous decision against you. All the very best, guys. Take care. Have a nice day.